our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Today we celebrate the feast of the conversion of St. Paul, and we remember at Mass Marcellina Caballos. And as we enter into these sacred mysteries, we ask God's forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who taught the whole world through the preaching of the blessed Apostle Paul, draw us, we pray, nearer to you. Through the example of him whose conversion we celebrate today, and so make us witnesses to your truth in the world, for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Saul, still breathing murderous threats against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues of Damascus, that if he should find any men or women who belong to the way, he might bring them back to Jerusalem in chains. On this journey, as he was nearing Damascus, a light from the sky suddenly flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" He said, "Who are you, sir?" He replied, "Cain, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. Now get up and go into the city, and you will be told what you must do." The men who were traveling with him stood speechless, for they heard the voice but could see no one. Saul got up from the ground, but when he opened his eyes, he could see nothing. So they led him by hand and brought him to Damascus. For 3 days he was unable to see, and he neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias, and the Lord said to him in a vision, "Ananias." He answered, "Here I am, Lord." The Lord said to him, "Get up and go to the street called Straight, and ask at the house of Judas for a man from Tarsus named Saul. He is there praying, and in a vision he has seen a man named Ananias come in and lay his hands on him, that he might regain his sight." But Ananias replied, "Lord, I have heard from many sources about this man. What evil things he has done to your holy ones in Jerusalem. And here he has authority for the chief priest to imprison all who call upon your name." But the Lord said to him, "Go, for this man is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before the Gentiles, kings, and children of Israel. And I will show him what he will have to suffer for my name." So Ananias went and entered his house. Laying his hands on him, he said, "Saul, my brother, the Lord has sent me. Jesus, who appeared to you on the way by which you came, that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit." Immediately, like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. He got up and was baptized, and when he had eaten, he recovered his strength. He stayed some days with the disciples in Damascus. He began at once to proclaim Jesus in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. All who heard him were astounded and said, "Is this not the man who in Jerusalem ravaged those who call upon his name, and came here expressly to take them back in chains to the chief priests?" But Saul grew all the stronger and confounded the Jews who lived in Damascus, proving that this is the Christ. The word of the Lord. The response, "Go out to all the world tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, O you nations. Glorify Him, O you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast is His kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Praise to you, Lord, in Jesus Christ.
Jesus' ministry, we know, was to the poor, the marginalized, and we're told also that he had ministered to people with hardened hearts. Well, we all know that there's nothing really, there's no such thing as a physically hardened heart. But when we talk about hardened hearts, we know exactly what that is. And Jesus in his ministry was capable of softening people to be accepted. It's the same thing with blindness. Some scholars will say, we heard in this reading from the Acts of the Apostles, that scales fell from Saul's eyes. And some of them will say that it was cataracts. Regardless of truth. Regardless of that was the case, something happened. More often than not, probably when Jesus cured blindness, it was spiritual blindness. When people, they had their aha moment. Now, I see what it is. So, let's pray on this feast of the conversion of St. Paul for the times when our hearts become hardened and when we become spiritually blind, that if we pray and open ourselves up, we too will have an aha moment. Bless you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth is given, and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Bless us, our prayer.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine of offer. The fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed are you, Lord God.
Wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Spirit fill us with that light of faith with which he constantly enlightened the blessed apostle Paul for spreading of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, our children, protect them always, so that it will be governed by those who have appointed shepherds,
to lead in the name of your Son. And so, with angels and archangels, and thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord of hosts, heaven and earth, O Lord, your Lord, whose hosts on high is the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, whose hosts on high is the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, gave thanks, and broke it. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ has risen.
Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. With Francis our Pope, Kevin our Bishop, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Blessed Apostles, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's say the prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Peace to the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's share that peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which the blessed Apostle Paul burned ardently as he bore his concern for all churches.